Welcome to Robotic Planet.
Hi, I'm Louis, and the launch of the upcoming Blender Hard Surface Robotic Planet course is getting very close, so I thought I'd give you a quick breakdown of what we'll be doing. In a nutshell, we'll be creating these two robots from the ground up. We'll turn our hand to non-destructive modeling workflows throughout, stacking modifiers so we can always go back and tweak proportions. We'll look at how we can achieve smooth, facet-free curves by exploring techniques that enable us to keep a low-resolution manageable base mesh with a high-resolution polished surface. Next, we'll look at making these surfaces pretty. Procedurally. No UV unwrapping, resolution limits, or large image sets. We'll be creating a set of easily reusable node group materials and masks, which, along with the asset browser, can be easily reused in any project. We'll jump into rigging by referencing real-world examples and then creating our own armature. Exploring how we can use constraints, drivers, and custom properties, even a little bit of geometry nodes, to automate what would otherwise be a tedious animation task. But we'll also be learning animation theory, mimicking inertia and increasing appeal with anticipation, follow-through, and overlap. We'll also look at how we can create secondary animation with very little work, as well as some shader animation techniques that don't put too much pressure on your graphics card. We'll be looking at why dropping in an HDR environment and calling it a day might not be the best approach for lighting our bots, and explore how to achieve a seamless looping animation, ideal for sharing online. We'll jump into Blender's built-in compositor to refine our render, adding film-like texture as well as a little color correction and color grade. We'll even look at the more recent real-time compositing options to see our adjustments live in the viewport. We'll then use geometry nodes to speed up the process of scattering rocks and plants in our environment, as well as a solution for automating certain ambient motion. This is all well and good, but I want to make my own robots, I hear you say. As well as coming away from this course having made an asset library full of useful building blocks, we'll also be covering techniques to help you think of and develop your own robot ideas. I have spent a long time optimizing workflows to find a balance that gives these animations a refined look without having an overly complicated pipeline. And I'm sure that you'll pick up a lot of smaller tips and tricks along the way. I'm really excited to be sharing this course, and I hope to be creating robots with you very soon.